I'm building a quadcopter today, but this is not a quadcopter build video. This is a flight controller review. When I went to build a quadcopter, I got a trip coming up, and I'm going to smash some quadcopters during this trip, and I looked at all the, I don't have enough quadcopters to go on this trip and feel confident. So I was like, I got to build a quadcopter at the last minute, and I went into my closet where I keep the giant pile of stuff that people have sent me to review that I haven't reviewed. I feel bad about it because, like, if people ask me, will you review this, and I say yes, then not 100%, probably I'm going to review it if I say I will. But people just sometimes send me things. I know, it sucks, right? Oh, it's so hard to be a YouTuber. I get things in the mail, and then people are like, hey, are you going to review that? And I'm like, well, you just sent it to me. I didn't, well, thank you, but today is lucky day for this, the Z's flight controller and ESC, because they're going to go into my build. And as I looked at it, I was like, oh, this is pretty cool, actually. And so I wanted to tell you about it. We'll start with the ESC. Let's just get this out of the way. It's a 60-amp BLW32 ESC. It's got a metal heatsink on it to help suck away some of the heat, keep those FETs cool, and it advertises having Toshiba FETs. Okay, great. I guess that's good, right? I don't know what the voltage rating of the FETs is. And frankly, most BLW32 ESCs perform about the same. It's just a question of how hard you can push them before they explode. The 60-amp rating on this suggests that it'll do a pretty good job, but obviously, only time will tell. I do like that the ESC has solder pads as well as the plug. So if you didn't want to use the 4-in-1 plug, or it maybe like the plug broke and you didn't have a spare, I really like it when they break out solder pads. It also makes it easier to test. If you need to test like VBAT or whatever, you can test on the solder pad with your multimeter. You don't have to try to get into the pins. So that's nice. So it's a fine ESC. Not much more to say about that. But the flight controller, really kind of cool. And the cool part of the flight controller comes into play when we flip it over, because on the underside, there is a direct solder location for a Crossfire Nano receiver and a TBS Unify Nano video transmitter. You can direct solder it right onto these pads, and that makes for a really low profile and lightweight build. No wires, no screwing around. And so that's why we're going to put it in this one. That's pretty freaking cool. Now, this is an F7 flight controller, so there's no nonsense with UARTs and inversion and SBUS and all that BS. But they have done some pretty interesting things to try and make room for this, all this dead space on the bottom. Well, it's not dead space, but they need the space to be clear, and so they've had to make some compromises. So, for example, here on the camera header here, well, first of all, the solder pads are they're kind of small. Beginners may struggle to solder to them. And the labels are squinched off to the side here. And we've got U6RX, that's presumably UART6RX. But then we've also got a solder bridge here to choose between CAM-C and UART6TX. And basically what it looks like is you get TX or RX, but not, or CAM-C, but not, you see, you're going to have to give up a UART to get any of those functions. You're going to have to give up one of those functions to get the others, just because there wasn't room to put them all on here. Over here for the Crossfire receiver, if we flip this over, we can see UART4, TX, and RX. And then here they've got UART2, TX, and UART1, RX. I'm going to guess that is for a FreeSky RX-SR, because SBUS and SmartPort would use the UARTs that way. And it does look like you're going to lose those UARTs if you cover them up with the Crossfire. So it's a classic example of how when you get really specific with your layout, you can get really compact, but at the same time, you give up some flexibility. Oh, there's another thing here that's interesting. These four outputs here are LED strip outputs, and this one has come. I'm not sure if they all come with this. Maybe they do, but mine came with these little 10 LED strips that you can put on the arms of your quadcopter or something, and they plug right into the flight controller here and are controlled by the Betaflight LED strip function. So we're going to try those out as well and see how they hold up. Well, I did notice something about the ESC that stands out. Not all ESCs are created equal after all. Some of them come with these little tiny holes in them to help you mount the capacitor. What you do is, let's make sure I got this right, negative to negative, okay. What you do is you stick the capacitor through here like so, and then you just take and you solder the XT60 up, or however you like to do it, but it just holds the capacitor in place, so it's one job to solder the capacitor and the XT60. That's actually a really nice feature. So here's how this works. The flight controller comes with these pin headers, a little 4-pin header for crossfire, presumably, and a 5-pin header for RxSR, I guess? I'm not really sure. And we're going to just insert that and solder that onto the Crossfire Nano receiver. This little putty here is called Blue Tack, and it is super useful for soldering things like this. And there's a link to this and all the other tools that I use on my website, fpvknowitall.com, link in the video description. Now, I haven't soldered a pin header in a long time, but I used to solder pin headers more back when I did like Arduino stuff more than quadcopters. And here's a little tip for soldering pin headers. Don't solder all of the pins at once. Solder just the first pin, and then look, you see how they're crooked? What we can do is I'm gonna touch this pin right here while I apply heat to this pin. Don't touch the pin you're applying heat to, or you'll burn your finger. I know, it sounds obvious, and yet. And then I'm just gonna flow this and then straighten the pin header out and then let it solidify. And then let's just double check the fit up before we commit. Yeah, it looks pretty good there. I'm thinking we should put some tape or something, though. I'm going to go ahead and solder these pins on permanently, then we'll figure it out. The problem I have with direct soldering things like this is it's oftentimes hard to remove if you don't have a hot air rework station, if you just have a soldering iron. Getting all of these pins to flow at once so you could desolder them would be tricky. And a lot of times, if you don't have a hot air gun, which I don't, why don't I have one? I don't know. You'll damage things trying to get it undone. So wires, at least, you can always desolder. But this seems reasonably rework friendly. Here's what let's do. Let's get some of this tape. This tape is sold as servo tape, but it wasn't what I meant to buy when I bought servo tape. But I think it's going to be actually really perfect for this application because it's kind of thick and springy. This is growing on me, I have to say. Let's just get these pins in contact and we'll just press that down. Can it come from the outside? Oh, that got it. That wasn't too bad. The mistake I made was I needed to solder just the first one and then kind of squeeze it down and flow it like I did just so it was held correctly. And now that I've had to desolder it, everything has gone foof-for-raw. That was as much of a pain in the butt as I was afraid it was going to be because I didn't do it right the first time. That's the problem. I guess I could have like maybe sucked out the solder completely. I don't know. So like when you do it with wires, you see it's still not even straight. When you do it with, her felted joint crack, isn't that wonderful? When you do it with wires, if you screw it up, you just desolder the wire and you get back on with your life. Doing it like this, you got to do it right, or you got to actually like really know how to solder, I guess is what I'm saying. Well, as promised, there it is, all soldered up in the quadcopter, including the LEDs, which I haven't yet put on the arms, but you get the gist. And especially if I was using the Unify Nano here, which it only goes up to 400 milliwatts, I'm pretty sure that's right, which I like to have more for freestyle, just you want all the output power you can get. But especially if I was using the Unify Nano, this would have been a pretty quick and compact build. Just easier to solder pins than to solder wires. But I'm not sure. Here's what I think. If you do this exactly right, then it's going to be pretty cool, especially if you put it like in a really compact frame, like a racing frame. it's going to just have everything so good. But I would not recommend this for a beginner. The soldering is pretty fiddly. The pads are pretty small and they're pretty close together. And soldering these pins on, if you screw it up, then you're going to end up in a mess. And there's a fair chance that in trying to undo your mistake, you're going to rip some of the pads off or damage your stuff. Which is, as much as I solder, I still don't like doing this stuff because I just don't like having to clean up and rework. With wires, you make a mistake, you undo the wire, you do it again. Your mistakes can only be so bad. But with something like this, once you've got all four of these soldered down, you now if you've made a mistake, you really are locked in. It's bad. It's pretty cool. The other thing about this is that as I was soldering it up, I was like, you really got to think beforehand to make sure you're going to have the number of UARTs and pads you need. It says on the spec sheet it has 6 available UARTs, and that's probably true, but the exact way, like, some of the UARTs are covered up by the receiver, some of the UARTs it's like a TX here and maybe an RX there or maybe camera control. I haven't dove into the manual, but it doesn't feel to me from looking at the pad layout like you actually have 6 full UARTs. You got a TX here for smart audio. You got an RX here for smart port. Anyway, so think very carefully about how you're going to do your wiring diagram before you commit to this. That being said, if what you've got is Crossfire, Unify Nano, camera, it's going to go together really good if you're up to it. I guess I would say this is pros only, and only if you are 100% sure it suits your needs. But it's pretty freaking cool. And if you decide that you are the kind of person who wants it, there's a link to it in the video description. It's an affiliate link. And that means that if you make any purchase after, I almost forgot my spiel. If you make any purchase after you click that, when people say, well, how do I get a link to such and such a product? They're all a link to every product. Just click the affiliate link, do your shopping. I get a small commission. It means a lot. Link to this product. Thank you, Z's, whoever the heck you are. Z's of Italy. Thank you for sending... I hate that. Turn the volume down there. Thank you for sending me this product, Z's.